Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And today, first of all, if you don't know who I am, my name is Meg. If you're new, okay. I wanted to show you today what my collection of secondhand shoes look like. Now, I only have four because I mentioned in a previous video before that I don't typically buy secondhand shoes, especially leather ones because you can't really wash them. But I do have a few here, and you would have seen it in the thumbnail, that I got secondhand because I wanted to buy them. They're pretty expensive new. Plus, not only that, if it's already been made and it's in good quality, it's fine, okay? So I'll start off with this pair right here, which are from the Nordic Fusion, and they're a pair of clogs. They're sandals. They're size 36. I am typically 37, but with open-toed shoes like these, they actually fit me as a 36. So that's what it looks like sideways, and it's a tanned color. It's beautiful. And I think I got this for something like $20 on eBay, and these retail for something around $100, $140. They are real wood with rubber soles and real leather. So they're really, really nice looking. It says it's made in Sweden. So yeah, that's what that looks like. And I haven't actually worn this because it's still quite cold here in Australia at the moment, but this I am looking forward to wearing in the summer, okay. So, and I chose this like neutral color so that it will suit with anything. Even thinking about wearing it with these overalls that I'm wearing at the moment. These are denim overalls actually, but it looks white on screen. It's too saturated. Yeah, but these are nice. They're from the brand Rolla and obviously also secondhand. Okay, so that was the first pair of shoes that I got secondhand. The next one is a pair of leather shoes from the brand Wittner, which is made in Australia. So these are these laced loafers that has sort of a hole in the middle. Yeah, so you can see that. Now these are really, really nice, and I like their pointed toe kind of shape and sort of that leather weaved look. Okay, I got this for $18 at the local Vinnie's, which for those of you who aren't from Australia is a St. Vincent de Paul charity shop. So I don't know why the owner donated this, but it was in really good condition. Like you can't even tell that it's already worn. The only way that you'd be able to tell that is when you put it on and you don't have to break it in. So it's made of really soft leather. It's beautiful. And yeah, for the price of $18, I didn't think that it was a bad deal. I wear this for work most of the time. And because of the way it looks and that cutout design that it's got, it actually works with trousers and skirts at the same time. You can wear it with leggings or with bare legs and it still looks beautiful. So this I thought was definitely a win. And Wittner here in Australia, I think a pair like this would set you off at around $120, and I paid $18 for it. Yesterday, I went to a shop called U-Turn Vintage, and I wasn't really planning on it, but my bus was late, and it was right there, so I went. And I found these. Now these, I wasn't looking for these kinds of shoes, but when I saw it, I just couldn't let it go. These are sort of like, I don't know what kind of material you would say this is. It almost looks like patent leather. And these are by Lacoste. Okay, you can probably see, yeah, on this side. On the white bit, it says Lacoste. And then at the very end, there's like a round button that has got the alligator on it. So this is a size 38, which is normally a size bigger than what I would usually wear. I usually wear 37, but this is a European 38, a UK 5, or a US 7. But when I tried it on yesterday, it actually was a really good fit. Again, I don't know why somebody would have, this was made in Vietnam. I don't know why somebody would have given this away, because even the insoles of this thing look like it hasn't been worn. You can see the Lacoste label on there is still intact. It has doesn't look like it's been worn in. It's beautiful. The only indication that it's not new is there are some like discoloration on the sides here. I don't know if you can even tell that it's there. It's got it on this side as well, but even like the soles look quite new. You wouldn't be able to tell. I got this for $25, and shoes from Lacoste over here usually would be at around $150 or higher. I think the cheapest one I got from them was something like $80 because it was on 50% off plus another 20% on top of the 50% off when I go to the outlets. So this was really good. And even though it was a size larger than I usually wear, it actually fits really well. And I think maybe that's one of the reasons why the original owner let it go, because even though it's one size bigger for me, where my pinky hits the side, so around here, it's a little bit stiff and it hurts a little bit. So maybe if you were somebody who had wider feet and was 38, that's probably why this was given away. But for me, it was perfect fit. And today, just today, I went to another branch of U-Turn Vintage. I wasn't planning on it. Once again, I was going to go to Paddington Market, but because it was really windy today, they decided they weren't going to have the markets today. And on my way home, I passed by U-Turn Vintage and found these Timberland boots, right? Now this one is a size smaller than what I would usually wear, just like my Nordic Fusion sandals. This is a size 36, okay? But because it's leather and it's already been used before, it's been broken in, and when I tried it on, it actually fit really, really well. You can tell from the soles that it doesn't look like it's really been worn out too much, right? Yeah, it even has the price on there, which is $59, and these normally retail for something like $220, $230 here in Australia. Even the leather here is really, really well maintained. There's not a lot of scuffings on the shoes. There's a little bit of a stain at the tip of the shoe, but nothing that it just looks like it's been loved, okay? But really, it looks almost perfect. It even comes with the original laces, so I got that. The only probable indication that you would have that this was used was the insides. Like, the insoles are a little bit worn. You can even tell that some parts of it, if you can see that inside, it's like bubbling, like the leather is like, I'll pull out some, see? I don't know if you can see that, yeah, but that's part of the leather because it's getting worn. But other than that, everything looks really, really well. And for $60, which I know is still quite a lot if you compare it to how much thrifted or secondhand things are in the States, but I think it's because the States also throw away quite a lot of clothing. So yeah, anyway, so I got these for $60, and they, like I said, they usually retail around $220 to $250. They are very comparable to Doc Martens. I was initially looking for black Doc Martens, but I saw these and I was like, stop the yard, boom, boom, boom. So I got these and I'm very happy with them. And yeah, I think that's it. So four pairs of secondhand shoes. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna stop rambling on. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know if you have ever bought any like shoes secondhand, and if you have, what are they? And what are your criteria for deciding whether or not you're going to buy a pair of shoes secondhand? Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!